So I'll start first by introducing myself and my project. My name is Bassem El-Shafei. I'm a second year PhD student. My project is about running wind simulations and measurements to have data fusion for wind resource assessment, both spatially and temporally. So our experiment, or the data collected, was generated from the Rune experiment carried in Denmark by DTU, the Technical University of Denmark. And I start by the assessment process. So assessments of wind speeds are critical to the pre-construction of wind farms. That's because they give us a clear view of the potential, or the amount of energy we can generate from a potential wind farm. So we have an approach that we propose that combines two different techniques of measurements, LiDAR measurements and WRF simulations. WRF is the weather research forecast, which provides continuous but low fidelity data. I'll start with the left figure. We have U1 and U2. These represent two different wind speeds at two different positions. They correspond to an onshore point and an offshore point, respectively. The first method, which is the WRF, or the weather research forecast, as I said, provides a continuous time series, so the data is available at any point, at any time. However, the data is of a low fidelity, and we try to improve that by fusing it with a second technique that generates data, which is the LiDAR measurements. On the other hand, the LiDAR measurements provides the sparse time series. These are highly accurate, but they are sparse in both space and time, so we don't have them at every time step or at every point in the located area. We start with the temporal fusion. So we combine both results, or both time steps and time series, together using Gaussian process regression. And then we carry these results from the onshore point to the offshore point using a neural network, which is the spatial fusion sector of our work. On the right side, I have the flow chart that shows the steps and where every process or every algorithm is introduced. We start with the data selection, so that's the points that we're interested in. And then we pre-process the data using empirical wavelet transform. And then we do the Gaussian process regression, which is the temporal fusion. We aim for an RMSE less than one, because that's a standard for wind simulations. If the RMSE is not less than one, we can just simply redo the experiment, because Gaussian process is a trial and error. If it continues to give us a result or an RMSE greater than one, we optimize the hyperparameters until we achieve the desired RMSE. Then we do the neural autoregression with external input. That's an ARX neural network, which carries the results by training networks and testing on new data. So that's the spatial fusion, which carries this result to an offshore location. Again, the standard for it is 1 meter per second. Once that's achieved, then we have carried the low fidelity data produced by the WRF simulation onshore to an offshore point of a higher fidelity. So the case description that we have is a west coast in Denmark, carried by the DTU. We use LiDAR measurements and numerical simulations. The LiDAR measurements were conducted by dual Doppler scans. So these require two LiDARs at two different positions, position one and position three. How the dual Doppler scans work is that they generate a line of sight of several points. So that's the black dots here. They have generated 36 points, and at each of these 36 points, we have a time series for 3 months. On the other side, for the numerical simulations, we have data everywhere, every point, and at every time step. So the pre-processing algorithm, the empirical wavelet transform, we use this wavelet transform to smoothen the time series that we have. As you can see in the figure, the original data or the original time series, the blue one, has high fluctuations and very sharp spikes. This is not optimum for the Gaussian process as it works on generating functions of the time series. So we smooth it with the empirical wavelet transform, and as you can see, the result or the black time series is much more smooth than the original one. Okay, the algorithm for the Gaussian process. The Gaussian process is a non-parametric stochastic process. It uses the Bayesian approach. We have two defined parameters for the algorithm: the mean function and the covariance matrix. The mean function represents the trend of the function, while the covariance matrix represents the dependence of the structure. And since we're using two different fidelities or different levels of fidelities, we add the second time series as T prime S prime. So the function becomes the Gaussian process, a mean function, and then the covariance matrix, but with two different time series, T and S for the low fidelity and T prime S prime for the high fidelity. Then these are the results of the temporal fusion. We had the low and high fidelity data sets merged using a multi-fidelity Gaussian process regression. We followed three different hybrids. Hybrid one used only the WRF simulation and the LiDAR measurements, which is the far left figure. And then a second hybrid, we used the WRF simulation and the LiDAR measurements, but we also added the first and the second derivatives of the WRF simulation. And for the third and final, the method that we're proposing is the WRF simulation, but pre-processed using empirical wavelet transform, the first and second derivatives, and the vector components of the wind speed, U and V, which is the best fit of all three. We also carried a, on a separate iteration, we tried to compare our work for several points. So the left figures here, these are just for one single point, but the time series. So with respect to time, on the right side, we have 36 different points, but just for one time. The RMSE of each point is it's located in the figure. And then, as you can see, the red line is the first hybrid, the green line is the second hybrid, and finally, our blue line is the third hybrid technique. And it outperformed the other two at each point. And then to carry the results from the onshore point to an offshore point, we trained a neural network. This is a nonlinear autoregression with an external input. It's a recurrent network with feedback loops. The model works on a dynamically on a function which carries the results from one step or one point at a time to the next step. So the way it works is the network works on understanding where every point is to understand where, what or to expect and predict what the next step is or what the next point is going to be. Here we have the results of the NARCS experiment. So for the LiDAR measures, the measurements that we provided, those are the blue lines, are the blue dots, and the results are the red dots. However, the results were generated from the onshore point. So we used the onshore LiDAR points and the offshore WRF simulation to generate the offshore LiDAR measurements. And we compare them here with the LiDAR measurements, and they were more accurate than the WRF simulation of the offshore point. So finally, for the one point or the one dimension experiment, we combine both techniques for a spatiotemporal fusion, GPR and NARCS, Gaussian process and neural networks. You can see here, instead of having just the red dots for the LiDAR measurements, we were able to generate a full time series of the offshore point, which is also more accurate than the WRF simulation. further or the future work, which we started already, is we're aiming to do more experiments at three different levels of fidelities. So the work that we've already done includes LiDAR measurements as the high fidelity work and a WRF simulation as the low fidelity work. What we tried for this iteration is another or a second WRF simulation of a lower resolution than the one used. And as you can see, that's the line, well, the best fit line here is the three layers orange line, and that has an improved percentage of around 6%. In addition, we're trying to work on a 4D model, one that takes or covers the entire area of the experiment area. So both X, Y, and Z in space, these are east, north, and the height. And also we're covering the time space. So, I mean, the time domain. So for this, we're using a matrix factorization technique. As you can see here, that's the original matrix, or the original matrices, where the white boxes represent the cells with empty data. These are the cells where the LiDARs weren't able to cover or to generate any observations. For three different heights, the columns of the matrix represent different points, while the rows represent the time domain. So every column here is a time series for one point. We use matrix factorization with Gaussian process again to fill in the matrix and do matrix completion. Here are like our preliminary results. We conducted the experiment three times with different measures. We reduced the number of LiDAR points to reduce the sparsity or the measurement density in the matrix. The final one is 16 LiDAR points. The top three ones show the preliminary ones, where the white is an empty cell with missing data, and the bottom ones reflect the final matrix with the predictions. We're also carrying different experiments to see how pre-processing the matrix with empirical wavelet transform can improve the predictions. We're carrying this work with the University of Edinburgh to reduce the working time or the processing time using their parallelization, their parallel Python codes. So the summary of our work is that we were able to join the WRF low fidelity simulations with LiDAR high fidelity data. We carried this for one point or a one dimensional time and space to obtain a single step spatial temporal fusion. For the time domain prediction, we used the empirical wavelet transform for effective smooth transformations and increasing the number of useful additional information, that's the derivatives and the U and V vector components of the WRF simulation. For the space domain data fusion, we were able to generate accurate offshore results from only the onshore data, which is highly likely to allow us not to send LiDAR equipment offshore because they usually get damaged due to the harsh weather conditions. The spatial temporal fusion performs better than the WRF simulation and requires less time, and the method was found to be promising for use at different levels of high fidelities, and we're trying to add even more levels of fidelities, which is the third or the second WRF simulation as a third level of fidelity. There are two publications by the university, the Technical University of Denmark, explaining the area of the experiment and the equipment that they used, the LiDARs and the dual Doppler scans. For any additional information, these are my contact details, and I'll gladly accept your questions now.